From women of the past to women still alive today, we've rounded up some of the most horrible to talk about today. On a list that is certainly not for the faint of heart, we have, in no particular order, the top 10 women in history we wish weren't born. Starting off this list in our number 10 spot, we have Clara Mowerova. Clara was nicknamed to be the cannibal mother and was one of three involved in the Curram case. Basically, Clara met someone who convinced her to join this kind of a cult that was led by someone who was called the Doctor. After joining this cult, that same woman, who was called Barbara, started to convince Clara to commit certain crimes against her own family. A lot of these crimes are one that I unfortunately cannot even repeat here on YouTube. These crimes continued on for a year until somehow a neighbor of Carla's bought a nanny cam that was on the same frequency as one that Carla was using, and the neighbor's camera's feed ended up getting intercepted with Carla's, and this neighbor saw some of the crimes happening and took the evidence to the police. Thankfully, this was enough for the police to come and take Clara into custody and charge her. The boys involved were able to testify at the trial as well. In our number 9 spot today, we have Irma Greece. I don't care if I say any of these names right, they all suck. Irma was given the nickname the Hyena of Auschwitz, and I think that really speaks for itself. She was a concentration camp guard and even went on to serve as warden of the women's section of Bergen-Belsen. There are many accounts of Irma and the crimes she committed, and they are all absolutely horrific. It is said that she was particularly cruel and stirred panic and fear in every prisoner that crossed her path. Apparently, she even had a lampshade that was made out of the skin of three separate prisoners, just as an example of how depraved she really was. These crimes caught up with her in the end, however, as in the spring of 1945, she was arrested along with 45 other people. She was accused of war crimes, and although she pleaded not guilty, the testimonies of witnesses and strong survivors allowed the truth to come out. She was convicted and sentenced to death, which occurred on December 13th, 1945. In our number 8 spot today, we have Leonarda Cianciulli. Better known as the soap maker of Correggio, Leonarda was an Italian serial killer who lived from 1883 until 1970. There are certainly people on this list who took more lives or did what could be considered more brutal things, but these crimes are absolutely chilling. Leonarda took the lives of three separate people and turned them into soap and tea cakes using caustic soda. Leonarda's son went to join the Italian army in preparation for World War II, and during this time, she figured the only way to protect him was by doing human sacrifices. One of the worst parts of these crimes is that she fed these tea cakes she made to people who would come to visit, along with eating them herself and feeding them to her son. Authorities caught on to her crimes when one of her victim's family members began to get suspicious about the disappearance. In the end, Leonarda was arrested and charged and ended up being convicted to 30 years in prison and 3 years in a criminal asylum. In our number 7 spot today, we have Elizabeth Bathory. Elizabeth was a Hungarian noblewoman who lived from August of 1560 to August of 1614. While she was born into one of the oldest and most powerful families in Transylvania and was well educated and successful, she was also killing young women and bathing in their blood. Yeah, super weird and really not cool at all. Elizabeth has gone down as one of the most evil women in history because she was taking the lives of women who were her servants, and she was bathing in their blood because she believed it would keep her young. There's something that's telling me that this probably didn't work. I guess somebody should have told her about drinking water and leaving other people alone. It's way more efficient. Anyway, instead of being remembered as youthful and beautiful, Elizabeth is instead remembered as being a terrible, evil person who took the lives of somewhere from 175 to 200 women, but some accounts swear the number might be as high as 600. In our number 6 spot today, we have Herta Oberhauser. Herta was a German physician and convicted war criminal who performed absolutely horrific medical atrocities on prisoners at the Ravensbrück women's concentration camp. She was known for being a part of medical experiments like treating purposely infected wounds with sulfenamide, as well as bone, muscle, and nerve regeneration and transplantation. Herta was the only female that was a defendant in the Nuremberg doctor's trial, and she was convicted for crimes against humanity, but was only sentenced to 20 years in prison. She was released early for good behavior somehow, and ended up becoming a family doctor again in West Germany. That was until a survivor recognized her. Herta then had her medical license revoked and was fined. She tried to appeal but was rejected and never practiced medicine ever again. In our number 5 spot today, we have Myra Hindley. Myra is a woman who was in a relationship with a man called Ian Brady. Together, this couple has been referred to as, quote, two sadistic killers of the utmost depravity, and individually, Myra has been called the most evil woman in Britain. Between July of 1963 and October of 1965, these two together took the lives of 5 separate people. The pair were only charged for 3 killings, but both received received life sentences under a whole life tariff. After being arrested, she of course tried to pin all of the crimes on Ian and make up excuses for the crimes, like saying that she was running a bath while one of them took place, so what was she supposed to do? Luckily, somehow the judge was able to see through this ironclad self-defense. She ended up making several appeals against her life sentence and claimed that she was a reformed woman, but for some reason, no one believed that and she was never released. We have Carla Homolka. Carla is one of the worst Canadians out there. Carla, along with her partner Paul Bernardo, are often referred to as the Ken and Barbie killers, and while Paul started off his life of crime alone initially, he quickly brought Carla into it as well, as the crimes only progressed and got worse. After being found out, Paul was arrested and charged for his crimes prior to their relationship, and together the pair was charged with taking the lives of three separate people, one of them being Carla's own sister. The investigation of the crimes was quite difficult and complicated, and unfortunately there was no choice but to offer Carla a plea deal. If she fully cooperated with the investigation, she would receive only a 12-year sentence in return, and she accepted. Both Paul and Carla were convicted in 2005, and while Paul still remains in prison, Carla served her 12-year sentence and has since been released. She left Canada for a while, but unfortunately has since returned. In our number 3 spot today, we have Isle Cook. Isle was a war criminal who oversaw concentration camps that were run by her husband, Carl Otto Cook. She is well known due to her sadistic and brutal treatment of prisoners, and she became one of the first well-known people that committed these types of crimes to be tried by the US military. It is said that those being held at the camps with distinctive tattoos, Isle would take pieces of their skin as souvenirs. When being charged with her crimes, they included things like private enrichment, embezzlement, as well as taking the lives of some prisoners to prevent them from testifying. In the original trial, she was acquitted for lack of evidence, although her husband was sentenced to death by an SS court in Munich. After a few more trials, however, she ended up being sentenced to life in prison, and despite multiple appeal attempts, she was never released. In our number 2 spot today, we have Daria Nikolaevna Saltykova. That's the best we're gonna get. Daria was a Russian noblewoman and a serial killer from Moscow. She became well known for killing many of her serfs, mostly women, which is kind of similar to Elizabeth, who we already talked about today. Because of her ties to the Russian royal court and other Russian nobility, complaints about the deaths at her estate were initially ignored and only resulted in punishments for those who did the complaining. Eventually, however, relatives of those who had been killed were able to bring a petition to Empress Catherine II, who then decided to try Daria publicly. Investigations took 6 long years, where the investigating official counted up to 138 suspicious deaths, basically all of which could likely be attributed to Daria. In the end, she was found guilty of 38 of these crimes, but the Empress wasn't quite sure what the punishment should be, as the death penalty had already been abolished in Russia. In the end, Daria was chained on a public platform and made to wear a sign around her neck that detailed the crimes she committed. After this form of punishment, she was sent to jail to serve out her life sentence. In our number 1 spot today, we have Delphine LaLaurie. Delphine was a New Orleans socialite who was an evil person behind closed doors. It is said that in public, Delphine was polite and appeared as if she cared for those who were enslaved in her home, which is the most ridiculous sentence I've ever said, but that's what the accounts of people who lived at this time said. Delphine's social standing remained until, on April 10, 1834, authorities responded to a fire at her Royal Street mansion. When they arrived and went inside, no one was prepared for the horrors they were about to see, as they discovered bound slaves in her attic who had clear signs of violent behavior over a long period of time. Following this, her house was swarmed by an outraged group of New Orleans citizens, but somehow Delphine was able to escape with her family to France. While the angry group destroyed her entire home, Delphine never faced any punishments for her crimes, which is one of the most frustrating endings to this horrible, awful story. History can give us incredibly important lessons, and while we can't change our past, we certainly have control over our future. Although this was a list of specifically women, evil comes in all forms, shapes, and sizes. These people did atrocious things, but we can use these as examples of exactly what not to do. Thank you guys for checking out today's list, and thank you for sticking it out to the end, although this was a dark one. I've been your host today, Olivia Kozlowski, and I'll see you all next time for hopefully a more lighthearted list.
Bye.
In our number 3 spot today, we have Isle Cook. Cook. Isla? Isle? I don't know. I think it's Cook, but Isle? I don't know what that name is.